Now, let us talk about the concept of Roots blower. Now, this is the very first of the rotary compressors, right? So, this is how a Roots blower looks like. So, this is also called two-lobed blower. So, there are two lobes in this. So, this is the first lobe and this is the second lobe. One of these two lobes is connected to the prime mover, and the other one becomes a driven member of the entire arrangement. These two lobes are directly coupled, and this is called the casing. So these two are housed in this casing. So there are two sides to it. One is the suction side, and the other is the delivery side. Okay, now what happens is, due to the rotation of these lobes, now you can see that if this lobe on the left-hand side, if it rotates in the clockwise direction, this has to move in the anti-clockwise direction. Right, so right now this space is open for suction. So the rotation of these two lobes creates space for the suction and delivery or the movement of the working fluid inside this casing. So right now, due to the rotation, the suction takes place over here. So this will rotate and this will rotate in this direction. So as they rotate, so after some rotation, the lobe number one will become like this, and lobe number two will also become like this. Okay, and the entire space would be filled up by the working fluid. Okay, after some time, this lobe number one would become vertical and lobe number two would become horizontal. Okay, at this particular space, or you can say position, this entire region is now full of the working fluid. Okay, and some working fluid also fills up this space. Okay, now after another round of 90-degree rotation, this vertical lobe would again become horizontal, and this horizontal lobe will again become vertical. So at this point, what happens? This region, which was filled up with the working fluid, is now pushed out from the delivery side, and this mass of air which was taken in is now set up for the next cycle of the blower. Okay, so this is how the working is pretty much. So if you look at this, you would appreciate that there is no actual compression of the air. If I take the working fluid as air, okay, the air is not being compressed, rather it is being delivered from low speed at the suction side to high speed at the delivery side. Okay, so the entrapment of working fluid or air in the in, you know in this region, which is between the lobe and the casing wall, it allows for some compression or discharge of air from low speed to high speed. Right, now what happens is, due to the lobe movement, as this lobe uncovers this delivery port, so there's the delivery port or the delivery side. On the delivery side, you have high pressure. So this is high pressure as compared to on the suction side, which is low pressure. So as this port is uncovered, what happens is, a small volume or small mass of air flows back from high pressure to the suction side. This backflow is due to the back pressure, and we call this backflow. Okay, and this backflow happens till the time on both sides you have equal pressure. Okay, so if you look at that PV plot now, you have a constant volume intake, right? Let us say at pressure P1 over here. This backflow, due to this difference of the pressure on the delivery and the suction side, okay, your air is irreversibly compressed. Irreversible compression. and this is at constant volume. Because when the air flows back, it is entrapped over here, and this flow keeps on happening till the pressure becomes equal, and the continuous movement will now push this compressed air outside at high speed. Okay, so this is the irreversible compression that takes place due to this backflow. So you can say that in a roots blower, the compression actually happens with the help of the back pressure or the backflow. Okay, and P2 is the delivery pressure. Right. Now, we all know that we have assumed that the ideal work is always isentropic in this case, because this compression is isentropic, but in actual, it is not isentropic. So the actual work done is equal to minus VdP, or the actual work provided. Okay, so this would be V1 into P2 minus P1. That's the actual work input to this roots blower, and it is not isentropic. If you talk about isentropic work, okay, that would be gamma minus, or gamma upon gamma minus 1 into P1 V1, right, brackets into P2 by P1 upon gamma minus 1 by gamma minus 1. So this is the entire expression for the isentropic work. You all know this. Okay, so with a difference in the actual work input and the theoretical or isentropic work input, we come to a term which we call the efficiency of the roots blower. Okay, the efficiency of the roots blower is basically a ratio between these two works. Okay, now you know it's a energy consuming device, so theoretically we would want a minimum energy consumption. So at all times, the isentropic work is less than the actual work input. So your roots blower efficiency would be isentropic work upon actual work input, right? So this would be equal to isentropic work upon actual work input. Okay, so this gives you the relation for the efficiency of the roots blower, and this is how it performs. Okay, I hope you understood this video on roots blower. Now let's move on to the next video.